Yo, what's up guys, Complies here. So in today's video, I'm gonna be going over a couple of different ways that we can do stretch resolution for Apex. Now we all know why people love to play on stretch resolution. Get slightly higher FPS, slightly lower input lag, characters have bigger hitboxes, movement feels a little bit better. There's just so many positives to it. But most tutorials, and even in my old tutorials, I've only gone over one way to do stretch resolution, which is creating it through the NVIDIA control panel, which is very simple, very easy to do, but it's not the best method. Even if you choose display scaling in the NVIDIA control panel, it's not true display scaling, so there is some slight input lag. It's not going to feel as good as it should, and your mouse movements may feel a little bit weird. So I'll be showing you guys how to force display scaling with a separate program. So if you're a sweaty tryhard Wraith main who spams their kunai all day, you definitely want to stick around and watch that part. But before I show you guys how to do that and we get into the video, please remember to like, comment, don't forget to subscribe if you enjoy my content, turn notifications on so you don't miss any future videos, and be sure to check out my Twitch where I stream Apex just about every other day. So I think that's enough plugin for the day. I know a lot of people have been wanting this video, so without further ado, let's get right into it. Okay guys, now this first method I've covered a couple times on my channel, and it's fairly simple. All we're going to be doing is creating a custom resolution through our NVIDIA control panel. This is recommended for more casual players who don't necessarily care about having the best settings, they just want a good resolution that they like, and they don't want their desktop resolution to be stretched as well. So to do this, all we're going to be doing is right-clicking, go to our NVIDIA control panel, make sure we're on the change resolution tab, then we go down here to hit customize, create custom resolution, then we go to our horizontal pixels. Now the resolution that I recommend using is 1728 by 1080. I think that is the best resolution. It gives you a nice combination of stretch while still maintaining good visual clarity. So all we need to do in our horizontal pixels is hit 1728, come down here and hit test. Do you want to save this resolution? We hit yes. After that loads and everything is saved up here, make sure that is checked, and then hit OK. Now go down to adjust desktop size and position. Make sure we're on full screen scaling, and then you want to be performing your scaling on display. Now, not everyone is going to have this setting. Some of you might only have GPU. However, if you do have display scaling, you definitely want that on. And then check this box, override the scaling mode set by games and programs. Once that's checked, hit apply, keep these changes, yes. So now we're done in the NVIDIA control panel. Now we're going to be going into our game folders. So come down to your Windows search bar, type in save games, the respawn, Apex, local. The videoconfig.txt is the file that we're going to be changing. Go down a little bit over halfway, and then setting default res is what we're going to be changing. Default, it should be 1920 by 1080. We're just going to go ahead and turn 1728. Hit file, save, X out of that, and then we're going to right click properties, read only, apply, and then okay. Next, we need to find where Apex Legends is downloaded. So in order to do that, all we have to do is open up Steam, right click on Apex Legends, go to properties, local files, and browse. This will take you to wherever you installed your Apex Legends. Now all we have to do is go into our CFG folder, auto exec. Now these two settings right here, letterbox aspect goal and letterbox aspect threshold, are what we need to change. If you're playing on 1728 by 1080, you want that to be 1.6. Now this will make sure that all of the text and numbers on the screen align with the other elements of the HUD. Once you have that done, hit file, save, and the same thing as before, right click, properties, read only, apply, and okay. The last thing for this method that we need to do is go back into our Apex Legends with properties, and then in your launch options, you need to make sure you have this right here, plus exec auto exec, so that it runs those two commands that we just entered into our auto exec. But once you paste that in there, you're done with the first method. If you're truly sweaty tryhard player and you want the absolute best settings possible, the second method is going to be for you. Now, as a warning, a couple of downsides of this is that your desktop resolution will be stretched. It will be 1728 by 1080, so it will look a little bit weird. And also, in order to use your native resolution, it is going to be 60 hertz, but you're not going to be gaming that native resolution if you're watching this video trying to set up your stretched res. It's just something to keep in mind. As of right now, I'm not sure if there's a seamless way to swap between native and your stretched resolution while keeping forced display scaling. As far as I know, you can't do it at the moment. So the first thing we need to do is go back into our NVIDIA control panel. So we'll right click, click on the NVIDIA control panel, and then adjust desktop size and position. We need to enable aspect ratio, keep performance scaling on display, and also keep override the scaling mode checked. Once we do that, all we have to do is hit apply. Configurations have changed. Would you like to keep these changes? We hit yes. Now we're going to be using a third-party program called CRU, which is Custom Resolution Utility. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. So once we open up that folder, we're going to double-click on CRU. Now the first thing we're going to do is go down to our extension blocks. We're going to double click that, and this very last resolution, which is going to be our monitor's native resolution with the highest refresh rate possible, we're going to double click that, and in the top right hand corner we're going to hit copy, then we hit okay. Now we're going to go through and we're just going to delete all these. So click delete all, leave your data blocks the same, don't mess with any of that, click okay. In your established resolutions, go down here, hit none, uncheck all of those because we're not going to be using any of those. In our standard resolutions, hit delete all, we're not going to be using any of those either. Now go up to the detailed resolutions, hit delete all. Now we're going to enter in the new one, so we'll click add, and in the top right hand corner hit paste, so it pastes all the values values from before. And the only thing that we're going to be changing now is the horizontal pixel setting. So we're going to be changing that to 1728. Once we do that, we hit okay, and then we hit okay again. Now in other tutorials, they'll tell you to use restart 64. However, I found it better just to restart my computer because when I use restart 64, I've gotten multiple black screens. Now, if you're still getting issues with black screens and restarting your computer, I will leave a link to a couple of troubleshooting guides in the description below. However, this solved most of the problems for me. So go ahead and restart your computer and I'll see you guys back in a little bit. Now, this might feel a little bit weird, but that's most likely because we're in 60 hertz, but we're going to be changing that in just a second. So we're going to right click, go to our display settings. We're going to scroll down just a little bit. Make sure our main monitor is selected. And then we're going to change our display resolution to 1728 by 1080. Now, if we did this correctly, 1728 by 1080 should be your recommended resolution. We're going to click that, hit keep changes. Now it's going to look weird for a second. You're going to have some black bars on the side. And in order to fix this, scroll down just a little bit, go to our advanced display settings, choose your display, make sure it's on the right one. Now, right here, keep note of this, your desktop resolution and active resolution should be exactly the same if you're doing forced display scaling correctly. Mine isn't, however, but in order to fix that, all we have to do is scroll down to our refresh rate, click 144, which is my monitor's highest refresh rate, and that's going to solve all of the issues right there. If you follow all these steps correctly, your desktop resolution and active signal resolution will be the same, and that's how you know you've done forced display scaling properly. Now real quick, I'm going to go back into native resolution just so I can show you guys the last couple steps. So same thing as before, we're going to go down to Windows search bar, type in saved games, click on that, respawn, apex, local, videoconfig.txt, a little bit further down than halfway, default res, we're going to change that to 1728. Once you do that, hit file, save, and we'll X out of it. Then we're going to right click, properties, make sure read only is checked, hit apply, and then okay. Now we need to find where our Apex is downloaded, so we'll click on Steam. We're going to Apex Legends, right click it, properties, local files, and then browse. Then we're going to go to our CFG folder, autoexec.cfg, and then paste these in from the description below, matte letterbox aspect goal and matte letterbox aspect threshold. These need to be 1.6 so that your letters and numbers align properly with the other elements of the HUD. Once you do that, hit file, save, right click, properties, read only, apply, and then okay. Go back into our Apex Legends with properties. And then in your launch options, you need to make sure you have this right here, plus exec autoexec. So once you guys have loaded into the game, you should see that your stretch resolution is now enabled. In order to double check that, we're just going to go to our settings, go to video, our resolution, yep, 1728 by 1080. So that's going to be it for today's video. If you guys did enjoy this, please remember to put a like, comment, and don't forget to subscribe as well. Also, don't forget to turn the notifications on so you don't miss any more future videos. Be sure to check out all my social media links in the description below, but like I always say, most importantly, please be sure to follow my Twitch where I stream Apex just about every other day. That's it for me guys. I'll talk to you guys later. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Peace.
Oh, they're gonna be done fighting. Oh no, 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 no. What the fuck? Oh my god. What the fuck? What is going on?
Alright, duck.
Oh my god! There's a three stack! Leave me alone! Oh no, 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 no!
Alright, Debbie. Are you ready? Are you ready? I got pork chops tonight.
Yeah. Oni-chan.
There you go.